mi pasión por los caballos empezó cuando estaba muy chico. Lo bonito que son, la vibra que te dan. Yo creo que cuando montas a caballo te relajas mucho, te sientes, te desestresas. Pero yo creo que me gusta más la adrenalina, sería con más adrenalina.
Perhaps it's logical that Saul Alvarez might not find complete contentment in life's more tranquil pursuits. After all, at just 20 years old, he's one of boxing's most talked about prospects in years.
Yo me he puesto a pensar de mi vida, lo que me está sucediendo. Yo estoy viviendo mi sueño. La verdad que no pensé que fuera tan rápido.
Guanacatlan, Mexico is a dusty rural town about 20 miles outside of Guadalajara. And it's where the youngest of eight Alvarez children learned at an early age that he could hardly avoid standing out in a crowd.
Desde muy chico me di cuenta que pues era diferente a mis hermanos. Y siempre los amigos y todo se colgaban de eso. Decían pecoso, cosas así, ¿no? Pecoso. Pero eso me enojaba mucho cuando estaba chico y pues ya después de todo ya se la pensaban porque pues así les iba, ¿no?
Bueno, la primera impresión que me da su aspecto físico es el verle su pelo pelirrojo, su cara llena de pecas y todo, pero sobre todo una mirada muy pícara, muy inteligente su mirada.
José Reynoso nicknamed that kid Canelo, which means cinnamon in Spanish. Alvarez started boxing at age 13 and subsequently dropped out of school in the eighth grade to focus full-time on his new passion. Then at 15, he became a professional, motivated by a desire to be something more than ordinary.
Yo creo que el camino que tomé es por ser alguien en la vida. Yo desde que inicié en esto, en el boxeo, quise y quiero llegar a lo más alto, ¿no? Llegar a lo más alto. Dios me dio este don a mí y pues lo he sabido aprovechar y pues para adelante, ¿no?
Saúl el Canelo Álvarez.
Within 3 years, Alvarez made the transition from local attraction in Guadalajara to national sensation. Widespread exposure on Mexican television and knockout performances in the ring cultivated his celebrity, all while he was still just a teenager.
Ese look que sí llaman mucho la atención, mucha gente lo ve y dice, ah, el güerito, el Canelo, ese del pelo pelirrojo.
Yo creo que Saúl tiene algo que le dicen carisma, y eso es con lo que se nace. Entonces, la gente está complacida con él porque les ha respondido. No puede ser que nada más porque es diferente, porque está guapo, porque está joven, porque llama la atención. Pero si perdiera las peleas, te aseguro que no, la gente ya lo hubiera olvidado.
Vaya que el Canelo ha alcanzado la fama muy rápido, ¿no? Todavía no es un campeón mundial, que podemos decirlo, y que la gente lo identificara de esa manera. Y ha alcanzado la fama muy rápido.
Bien, eso, bien, bien, otra vez. Eso bien.
Thus far, Alvarez's professional accomplishments have yet to catch up to his level of stardom in Mexico. It's a disparity the fighter and his manager recognize, and one they believe that with time they can overcome.
Yo creo que él no, sus limitaciones o su, el límite él lo puede poner. Yo confío en que él llegue hasta lo máximo, pero por el momento falta todavía, y falta porque falta tiempo, falta la experiencia que dan las peleas grandes.
Siempre va a haber gente que pues te diga cosas, que no eres nadie, que eres producto de la televisión, que eres producto de muchas cosas, ¿no? Pues solo decirle a esa gente que para eso estamos aquí, ¿no? Yo creo que estoy demostrando lo que tengo, estoy demostrando cada pelea lo que tengo.
Perhaps if his life had worked out differently, Saul Alvarez would spend his days in charge of this modest ice cream shop in downtown Guadalajara. It's a place owned by his father, where Alvarez used to work every weekend as a boy. Instead, his ambition has him standing on the doorstep of something much greater.
Down goes Valdemir on a rocket left hook, and he knocked Valdemir out.
En México estamos necesitados siempre de héroes, de ídolos. Saúl es el gran prospecto que se tiene dentro del boxeo mexicano y que la gente lo quiere ver como un héroe mexicano.
Esas expectativas que tiene la gente de mí, yo creo que me tienen muy contento. Obviamente todo esto se hace paso a paso, pero voy a llegar a ser el Muhammad Ali. Quiero que en un futuro, cuando hablen de boxeo, se acuerden del Canelo.
Well, Saúl Álvarez has certainly embraced the stardom that's come his way. Now, we talked about the fact that he wasn't able to make the catch weight of 150 pounds. The great Juan Manuel Marquez took some shots at him and said it shows a lack of greatness on his part to not make a weight that he insisted upon. Max, what about all the hype around Álvarez?
Well, first, Marquez, a great veteran fighter, for various reasons was never able to connect with the boxing crowd as Álvarez has been able to do so far, and maybe he's a little bit bitter about that. You know, we all are looking for a new star in boxing, a big star, especially Mayweather's not fighting and Pacquiao's not fighting serious fights at the moment. In baseball, this is called wish casting, when you believe the prospects for your team are better than they really are. Are we wish casting with Canelo Álvarez? He's only 20 years old. He's already really good. We know that. We know he can beat the kind of minor league fighters. We know he can hit the fastball. Can he hit a curveball? Is Matthew Hatton the kind who can throw him one tonight?
That's going to be one of the questions here this evening. Can Hatton give him enough to really give him the proper test? Switch things back over to Roy Jones. And Roy, you know about the hype. You've seen Álvarez fight before. But does he have the goods to really be great?
Well, we're not sure if he has the goods yet. We do know one thing, though. We do know that he has different color hair, he has different color skin, and he definitely has a different style of boxing for a young Mexican fighter in the boxing ring. He doesn't come out just winging like Marco Antonio Barrera at age 15 did when he turned pro so early. He comes out and he methodically takes his opponents apart. I really like what I see in this guy, and I'm really hopeful that he has everything it takes to back up the huge following that he has developed.
Well, Matthew Hatton wants to give him a test tonight as we take a look at the tail of the tape, the 20-year-old Álvarez against the 29-year-old Hatton. You see the weights on the second weigh-in. Álvarez weighed in at 151 and 3/4, rehydrated on our unofficial scales all the way up to 165. Hatton, who made 149 and a half, rehydrated to 157 pounds. Max, let's take a look at the 154-pound weight class.
Well, as is our unfortunate policy, we look at belt holders. Cotto won against Yuri Foreman. Somehow that made him a belt holder. Zinzurek's really good. I mean, he's moving up to fight Sergio Martinez on HBO next week. That's a fight worth checking out. Cornelius Bundridge, you know, a veteran fighter, beat Corey Spinks for a strap. And now the stars of the division, the real stars other than Cotto. Manny Pacquiao, Shane Mosley have a fight coming up at welterweight. They both fought at junior middleweight. Paul Williams has fought at junior middleweight, though not recently. Margarito went the distance with Pacquiao. I guess that's something. And then the real up-and-coming young blood, Álvarez, you see tonight. Kirkland earlier tonight scored a first-round knockout. He's an animal. And Alfredo Angulo, though he can't seem to get out of Mexico nowadays, is a very exciting and fan-friendly fighter.
Now, coming to the ring, Matthew Magic
Hatton. Matthew Hatton, to quote him, said, "I've had a slow-burning career at the age of 29. It took him a while to break free from his brother Shadow. He's been with a new trainer, Bob Shannon. They feel that they haven't seen the best of Matthew Hatton yet. We're going to find out tonight against a really talented prospect in Álvarez."
Well, I don't think that Golden Boy, the promoter, thinks you're going to see the best of Matthew Hatton tonight, or he wouldn't be in the ring with Álvarez. Recently, especially, you see 10,000 people come out north of the border to see a fighter who really hasn't done much yet. He's done a lot for a 20-year-old Álvarez, but not by, you know, world-class standards he hasn't done a lot. Yet he can bring 10,000 people out in this country So Golden Boy is going to be careful with him before he hits the really big time, hence Matthew Hatton.
Yeah, Matthew Hatton is fighting for a 154-pound title tonight. I mean, he's been fighting at 147 pounds. But he says that he's a different fighter with trainer Bob Shannon, that Roy, the first thing that they noticed was footwork that had to be improved, and they feel that they have that, and that's kind of the key for them.
Ahora, damas y caballeros, Saúl Canelo Álvarez.
Matthew Hatton, will 10 years be a difference?
First of all, the fact that this is for a belt is a farce. Hatton's never fought at junior middleweight. They're contracted for below the junior middleweight limit. I like Canelo Alvarez a lot, but this is about as much of a championship fight as you and me putting on the gloves right now and that being for some kind of a belt.
Up to the ring and Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Honda Center, Anaheim, California, USA, Golden Boy Promotions, in association with Canelo Promotions and Hatton Promotions, are proud to present the main event of the evening, 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Super Welterweight Championship of the World. Sponsored by Tecate, Cerveza con Carácter, AT&T, Rethink Possible, DeWalt Tools, Guaranteed Tough, Tres Generaciones, Triple Distilled Tequila. Sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission, Chairman John Frierson, Vice Chairman Dr. Christopher Giza, and Executive Director George Dodd. World Boxing Council President Jose Suleiman. At ringside, the three judges scoring this bout: Raul Caiz Sr., Jack Reese, and Joel Scobie. And inside the ring, in charge of the action at the bell, referee Dr. Lou Moret. And now, to the memory of Greg Goosen, damas y caballeros, están listos. Are you ready for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world? Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black with gold, officially weighing in at 149, 1/2 pounds. 47 professional fights, 41 victories, including 16 knockouts with 4 defeats and 2 draws. From Manchester, England, the former IBO world champion and reigning European light middleweight champion, the WBC number 5 ranked contender in the world, Matthew Magic Hatton. And fighting out of the red corner, wearing purple, official weight 151 3/4 pounds. 36 fights as a professional, 35 victories, including 26 knockouts with one draw. Damas y caballeros de Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, the WBC silver belt champion and number one ranked contender in the world, the undefeated Saúl Canelo
When Wilfred Benitez won the junior welterweight title at 17, he had to beat the great Antonio Cervantes. Fernando Vargas, when he won a belt at the age of 20, had to beat the accomplished Yuri Boy Campos. This is not that, but Matthew Hatton is a proud fighter. He's shown up in shape and to win. And Canelo Alvarez is trying to keep this incredible momentum that he's built up going.
Underway round one.
First thing we're looking to see is to see how Hatton reacts to Alvarez's power shots.
Good stiff jab from Alvarez, and he throws a hook that Hatton blocked most of. Double jab for Hatton. Good right hand to the body from Alvarez. Wings the right hand up top.
You notice about Alvarez right away, Roy, heavy hands.
Heavy, heavy hands. And that's why I say he's a little bit different from most of the Mexican fighters that I've seen in the past. He's not a guy who comes in with mediocre hand speed or mediocre power. He has exceptional power.
Hook to the body, right hand from Alvarez, and he fainted and tried to lead right. Tempo here in round one, approaching the midway point of the round.
The problem with a fighter like Hatton in a fight like this is that I don't think he has the power to make Alvarez respect him at all. So there's no way really for him to keep Alvarez off of him. Now, if he can try to wear Alvarez down, that'd be smart because he's an older fighter, probably a little bit more conditioned fighter, and he probably can take more than Alvarez can.
He made weight. He came into this fight in better condition.
Hatton. His campaign mostly at 147, and he only has 16 knockouts in his 47 pro fights. Boy, you like that jab that Alvarez has?
He
calls it up with a hook.
Love that jab. The only thing you have to wonder about a fighter like Alvarez is at this age, is he throwing really powerful shots? And if he is, they will cause him to tire more in the long run. If he doesn't get a quick knockout.
Well, he threw a left and then a right hand that landed to the head of Hatton. Hatton tries to come back. Alvarez blocks the offensive.
10 seconds. See Hatton's games.
Good opening round of this 12-rounder.
Relax, relax a little bit, relax. Breathe now. The mouth guard, breathe. You did things very well now. The only thing, you know, you're like you weren't very intent on what you were doing. better be careful because you can connect you with one punch. Be more attentive and bend your waist. You know, but be a bit careful because he's got two hands. Remember that. You got to work that jab.
Good jab. You're going to come out, bang, bang, and count him with your right hand if you can. But just take that jab in his face. Get them fast hands working it. Turn him. Remember, just keep nice and tight. It's early doors yet. Yep. Early doors. Yep. Doing really well, right? Let's go. Nice and tight now.
In the first round, Alvarez landed 16 punches, according to CompuBox, of 59. 13 of them power connects, 13 of 35. Hatton just 7 of 42 overall. Hatton comes out with a double jab and a right hand to start round two.
Alvarez is so much bigger and stronger and heavier handed, but hasn't really landed much clean.
Doubles up that left hand.
Beautiful body shot.
Best shot of the fight for Alvarez so far.
And if Hatton waits on him, it's going to be a very short night for Hatton because this guy's a real power puncher. You can't sit back and let him just pick and duck hunt on you. He's picking shots and just banging them on Hatton, and that's not going to work good for Hatton in the long run.
What should Hatton be doing, Roy?
He got to attack and make it an ugly fight. Don't let the kid sit out and sit up. The kid is younger, he's bigger, he's stronger, so you must get close to him and make it an ugly fight. If you stay outside, you're not going to beat him.
He needs to be a little Ricky Hatton, Roy.
Exactly. He got to be a machine, like his brother. Try to wear Alvarez down. We're working. He said he's going to change his rhythm, but I don't see him doing that much.
I got to tell you, so far I think Matthew Hatton's fighting pretty well under the circumstances, you know, considering all the advantages you just laid out for Alvarez.
Ooh, good left hook to the potty by Alvarez.
Speaking of baseball metaphors, I mentioned before, the punches sound different when Alvarez throws them. They thud differently than other fighters.
Like I said, for a Mexican sensation, he's a very strong puncher.
Well, look at his legs. I mean, look at thick calves, thick thighs. He's got a lot of power base.
Everything about him is against the normal Mexican regimen.
He looks Irish. He is Mexican. He looks Irish, and he fights George Foreman.
Exactly.
And he uses that hook to the body, does Alvarez. Left hand to the chin, right hand to the nose, and some blood from Hatton's nose. As Hatton digs in with a couple of hooks, counter right by Alvarez, then a short right inside from Alvarez. Oh, good left hook, right hand, left hook again. Blood streaming out of the nose of Hatton. They both throw left, Alvarez is hurt more.
No respect at all for Hatton's power.
Right, just don't wear the feet when it's done. It's only your nose. Only your nose. Just go. You okay? Yep. Just that nose. Remember, don't stand in front of him now. Just get your second breath out. Feel head and use your jabs in it. Work them jabs. Don't stand in front of him. He was really moving well in the first half of the fight.
And there's Ricky Hatton, the brother of Matthew Hatton, seated at ringside. He's getting booed. He doesn't know why. They showed him on the screen. And the whole Hatton clan, mom to the far left. Girlfriend Jenna, Matthew there as well.
Weather the storm, right? Right? Get them jabs, remember, he's going to blow in the next half of the fight.
Yep.
Nice and tight, Matt.
Alvarez landed 21 of 49 power shots as charted by CompuBox in round number two.
He really started to walk Ricky Hatton, Matthew Hatton down at the end of that round. Started to care less about his power and started to impose his will on Matthew.
Mm-hmm. Roy, tell us what that feels like. I mean, you experience that where you just know that you are stronger and overpowering your opponent.
But once you get to that point, you feel like you got a guy out there in the middle of deep water who can't really swim, because there's not really much he can do. He can't really hit you. If he does hit you, he can't hurt you. So he's just, you're just playing target practice with him. You're just waiting on the shot that'll catch him, that'll either knock him out or knock him down, because he doesn't have a chance of doing anything to hurt you. And that's what Alvarez is feeling right now.
Yeah, it does already seem like the fight's moved to the point, even though Hatton's kind of boxing well, that it's like, oh, what's the point? You know, like, the point here is to see how long Hatton can stand in front of Alvarez, how much punishment he can take. Even though he's, you know, fighting rather well, I think, given the circumstances.
Alvarez opens up, uses that left hook to start the sequence. Hatton rolls off the ropes.
Watch your head, watch your head.
Left hand from Hatton, and then Alvarez fires back.
If Hatton could punch, this would be an interesting fight, because the one thing about Alvarez that he will have to change later on is that he's not afraid of getting hit. He does not run from punches at all. I mean, he tries to cover up a little bit, but...
Or move from them even.
Exactly. He's never really been afraid to get hit. And I noticed that in a lot of his earlier fights. Hasn't really learned respect for a punch yet.
Right, clean.
A little
right,
head movement right. Would serve him well.
Stop, 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 stop. Don't get caught up.
Roy, would you say that that's one of the areas of his game that he's got to improve upon as he moves up the ladder, his head, some head movement?
Has to improve on, I mean, immediately. Because if he becomes champ tonight, he's going to become a target right away. A lot of guys are sitting at home right now, such as Winky Wright, praying that he wins and looks for an easier fight and that they can get in front of him, because they see that he's capable of being hit and he doesn't really care about getting hit. And in pro boxing, that's one thing you have to learn to respect.
End of round three with Alvarez right hand. On March 26th, Boxing After Dark returns with featherweight titleist Yuriorkis Gamboa putting his belts on the line against Jorge Solis. Also that night, a matchup of undefeated up-and-comers when Matt Remillard takes on Mikey Garcia. On March 30th, just days before the Final Four, Real Sports premieres with a special episode on the NCAA. Among the issues explored, do college athletes deserve to be paid? And how would that impact the current system?
Took the shot, make him work, clip and then just to the shots like he did. Yep. Once that jab gets going, Matt, the all cut comes through. Yep. But you've got to clip him better. Just move, bang, bang. Hit and run, hit. Okay?
Al cuerpo,
work the body now, work the body. 2-3 rounds, Alvarez has outlanded Hatton 49-16 in power connects, according to CompuBox, as we check in with an unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Letterman.
Okay, Bob, 3-0, 30-27, Canelo Alvarez. You know, Bob, I got to tell you something. A number of years ago, one thing I really learned to appreciate from Roy Jones Jr., and that's a guy that can throw a 6-7 punch combination. And you watch Canelo Alvarez in the middle of the round. Man, when he lets his hands go, it's 5, 6, 7 shots at a time, and he lands most of them. I mean, he's a heck of a combination puncher. One thing he does bad, though, he'll move that right hand out to the side, then throw a double left hook. I think it leaves his jaw wide open. But here's the mate. One other thing I want to point out. He's wearing that Japanese boxing glove, supposedly to protect your hands. Now, I don't know if Canelo's got bad hands, but he's got the boxing glove. 3-0, Alvarez.
Good point Harold makes, that even though he doesn't have great hand speed, Canelo, he nevertheless puts punches together.
And he does have good power, so maybe he's using those gloves for protection.
And he won't turn 21 until July 18th.
You talk about the recipe for a great action fighter, a heavy-handed puncher who puts punches together and doesn't move his head. There are going to be some classic wars in his future.
That hurt really bad, left hand to the body.
Yeah, that hurt bad.
You saw Hatton sort of cover up. That one hit the sweet spot. Then he goes with a right hook to the body and a right cross from Alvarez. Doubles up the left hand.
There's a cut.
Cut over the left eye of Hatton. Plenty of time to go here in round four. Alvarez doubles up that left again and a right.
Oh, good shot. See, right there, he's not protecting himself. And a seasoned veteran will land big shots on him right there. That's the things he got to work on as he proceeds to go forward with his career.
Left, right to the body, right to the head from Alvarez.
He got to work on that defense.
Matthew Hatton's game.
Well, we know that if he's anything like his brother, that's one thing he definitely is game.
Runs in the family.
Maybe not as talented.
Definitely not as hard of a puncher.
Big round four for Canelo Alvarez.
10 seconds. Yes, Segundo.
Second time in Hatton's career he's been cut.
See Canelo try to motion the ref out of the way so he could get to Hatton there.
Just weather the storm now. Just weather the storm. Just weather the storm. Tony, Nick. Just weather the storm. He's getting tired now, this kid. Just listen, Matt. You okay?
Yep.
Get your head back on it now. Just nice and tight.
Yeah. Not hurting your toe.
Yeah. Remember, just cool down now. Relax. Just weather the storm now.
Right here, you see Canelo come in. He goes a right uppercut followed by a left body shot. A beautiful combination. Hatton's hands were up protecting his head. He never saw that body shot coming, and that's why it hurt so bad. Then Canelo follows with a right hook to the body, left hook to the head, and a right uppercut. A vicious uppercut that possibly caused the cut, if not that right hand over the top.
Yeah, referee Lou Moret informed me. I asked him in between rounds, accidental clash of heads or a punch. He said punch caused that cut. So if this fight gets stopped because of that cut later on, it's a win for Alvarez.
Stop. Watch those elbows.
Boy, what does Hatton need to do to sort of change the momentum here where Alvarez is just kind of walking him down and using big body shots to gain the momentum?
The first thing you got to do is you got to quit letting this kid back him up. Anytime you back up on a kid who's this strong, you give him room to use his power. He needs room to throw and to deliver those powerful body shots. So if you give him room like Hatton's doing, you're making it worse for yourself. If Hatton would just go at him and smother those powerful shots like that, it would be much better for him. But he's staying outside and he's allowing this kid to have room to deliver those vicious shots like that double hook he throws to the head and to the body.
Roy, Hatton's just got to hope that a clean shot opens a cut or something and they stop the fight because of the cut on a clean shot. I mean, I don't see how else he wins the fight.
Yeah, he's dead. He's starting to get tired. You're starting to see his punches fall off a little. And Canelo's just resting right now, taking his time. So if Hatton was a beast like his brother and was really coming at Canelo hard, we'd find out a lot about Canelo tonight.
Yeah. Although even then, he's so outsized in the fight, you know?
We're in Anaheim, California. HBO's Boxing After Dark. Bob Papa, Roy Jones, Max Kellerman. Saul Alvarez, 20 years of age from Mexico in the purple, 35-0 with 26 knockouts against Matthew Hatton, 41-4, 16 knockouts. Earlier tonight, Adrian Broner, unanimous decision win against Daniel Ponce de Leon. 96-94, and two of the judges' scorecards, 99-91. It was a closer fight than 99-91.
I mentioned earlier,
good left hand to the body by Alvarez again. Hatton goes back to the body.
That we know Alvarez can hit the fastball. Can he hit a curve? Can Matthew Hatton throw him a curve? Matthew Hatton's trying to throw him a curve. He's moving around him, stepping around him, throwing body shots, trying to throw his rhythm off. It's just that Matthew Hatton throws a minor league curve. That's why he's in the ring with Alvarez.
He's just too small, too light of a puncher.
That's it. This is about getting the promotional tool that is a title belt nowadays around Alvarez's waist, getting him more exposure on HBO, and getting people excited, and they should be excited about him. He's an exciting fighter.
10 seconds. Yes,
come to the end of round number 5 on HBO's Boxing After Dark. We're celebrating our 15 years of HBO's Boxing After Dark, and one of the classics on HBO's Boxing After Dark took place in 2002. One of the great fights of all time. Arturo Gatti and Mickey Ward in their first encounter.
Vicious body shots by Gatti. Ward nods as if to say, come on, come on. Come on, let's fight. Oh my God. What a fight. Well, we told you it might be a candidate for fight of the year. We didn't know it would be a candidate for fight of the century.
This is the way it has to end.
Well, what a performance by Mickey Ward and Arturo Gatti in that first meeting. Of course, the fighter movie, and the Oscars recently took place, and that fight was not included in the movie, but you know, Jim Lampley made a point, fight of the century. When this century's over and we're all long gone, that still will rank up there as one of the great ones.
It's just an amazing fight, and it shows you don't have to be the most talented guy in the world to inspire people.
Not at all.
And you don't need a belt attached to anything to have a legendary night.
And I was gonna say, to Alvarez's defense, he didn't ask for the belt. They offered to let him fight for the title. And if I were in his situation, coming up at 20 years old and got a chance to make history, of course I would accept the belt too. So
nothing against Alvarez, of course not. And it should be noted, Alvarez fought some tough guys early in his career when he was a teenager. Guys who went on to win significant fights. It's not as though the quality of his opposition as for a 20-year-old's been bad. It's been exceptionally good. It's just that now that it's apparent the kind of connection he has to the fans, his promoter is being very careful with him.
Without a doubt, but anytime you can get 35 wins in a row, I don't care what nobody say, something's good about you.
Oh, and you can see it. See what's good about this guy.
Well, Max, I think the point you brought up earlier, too, and he gets hit enough that as he moves up and through the ranks and starts fighting better level of opposition, it's going to create even more intrigue in his fights.
You never saw Roy Jones in a Ward Gatti-type fight, and that was on purpose.
You're exactly right.
Stop, 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 break.
I guess that's part of his heritage that he didn't avoid, because the Mexicans do not mind going to war, and I love him for that.
Barrera, just like Alvarez, turned pro at the age of 15 as a face-first brawler and wound up a consummate boxer puncher. Do you think, Roy, that Alvarez has the tools to wind up a consummate boxer puncher?
No, not at all. If you look at his attitude right now, his attitude is kill, kill, kill.
But that's attitude. Do you think he has the physical attributes to do it?
You can have all the physical attributes you want to have. If your mentality is kill, 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 and you punch like he punches, and you're built like he's built, then that attitude is going to reign supreme every time.
So you think there's a fundamental difference between him and a young Barrera, for instance?
Most definitely. Barrera was definitely a technician in the beginning. He just threw a lot of punches, but he was a technician who really didn't like to get hit.
Really, you think that?
First time I saw him, I said, here's a guy who's going to be on the top pound for pound list. Not because of his offense only, but because of his defense. If you look at this kid here, he's different because he don't care about defense.
He'll be in the top 5 pound for pound most exciting fighters around, that's for sure.
And the top 5 best punchers for this weight division.
He certainly likes throwing those hooks to the body, does Alvarez.
He's already a top 5 ticket seller, it seems.
Everything good? Yeah.
Toma aire, toma aire.
All right, breathe, breathe deeply.
Otra vez.
Again.
Todo bien. Hay que meterle un poquito más de velocidad.
You gotta put a little bit more speed into it.
Remember, keep them deep breaths. But every time you're moving, he can't catch you. He's setting you up all the time. He wants to set you up all the time with that, doesn't he?
Yeah,
doesn't he? So you've got to keep moving, clusters, right? Every time you catch him, them clusters, and you move, he can't catch you. He wants to set you up.
Here's the Alvarez and the hook to the head, that hook to the body with the right hook following it to the body, then coming back with another hook to the head. Beautiful four-punch combination.
We begin round number 7 in the scheduled 12-rounder between Saul Alvarez and Matthew Hatton. Harold Letterman, how do you see it so far?
Okay, Bob, 6-0, 60-54, Canelo Alvarez. Now, I know a lot of people are going to criticize me for round 4, which I scored 10-9. It could have easily been 10-8 because Alvarez won it so big. But there's it, mate. Canelo Alvarez doing more damage, landing the hardest shots, backing up Hatton, and just beating him up, and he's winning the fight. One interesting point. In California, the doctor has the right to stop the fight. If the doctor's sitting there and he says to himself, Hatton's taken enough, he can jump in and stop the fight. Even though it's not in the unified rules of the Association of Boxing Division. 6-0, Alvarez.
All right, Harold. It's not as if Hatton doesn't throw back enough. It's just you feel the will of Alvarez just wearing and wearing and wearing on Hatton. What a combination by Alvarez.
Alvarez, in certain respects, also showing some patience here. You know, he's coming forward, he's throwing and landing the big shots, trying to catch him in an exchange. But it's not like he's just throwing caution to the wind and trying to run over him, Roy.
No, he's not. He's being very smart what he's doing.
Until that late shot just then.
Referee Lou Moret calls timeout.
Okay? Okay, the man. Wait. 1 point. Hit him. 1 point. Hit him. 1 point. Hit him on the break.
Who did he take the point for?
Come on, break.
Took it from Alvarez.
Let's stop it now. Let's go.
He didn't get him in point to it like he took it from. You think he's afraid of the fans? He's supposed to grab that fighter by the glove and say 1 point from this guy.
Well, Alvarez wants to get that point back. Vicious body shot from Alvarez on Hatton here in round 7.
Listen to this crowd. Music. Alvarez's fans want to cheer for him so bad.
Hatton's only been stopped once in his career. Fights back and eats a right hand. Hatton comes back with a left and holds on. Has weathered the storm here in round 7.
Mr. Fight Hatton has been leading all night. This is a safer fight for him. Either get it or get it.
I think he's going to get it, Roy.
Listen, don't be the macho man. Are you listening? Don't be the macho man. I want you to box out with your box these fight then. Are you listening?
Yeah.
Box our fight, speed and agility. Are you listening?
Yeah.
You took a lot out of him then, so we can take the next time, but you've got to fight our fight. Are you listening?
Yeah.
Fast stands now, right? Next, I want you out there moving with the jab.
Get over my head back and
right. I don't know. Use that.
You've got to fake him.
Hay que fintar.
You've got to fake him.
Here they were tied up. Hatton hit him behind the head. So he hits Hatton in the face on the break, but the ref had already called for a break by the time he hit Hatton in the face. So that's why I think the ref took a point.
Round number 8. In the last round, according to CompuBox, Alvarez landed 33 of his 47 power shots. Hatton threw 33 in the entire round. Punches total.
And nothing against Hatton's corner, but I feel like they gave him the wrong advice. They told him not to go in the fight bullish, but you can't outbox this kid because the kid punches too hard from outside. So why would you stay outside and allow him to pop you with these big punches? The way Hatton should be fighting is inside, making a rough fight, and throw as many short, quick punches on the inside as he can. That's the safest thing for him.
Or at least it's the one strategy that maybe on the outside could result in success, because the other strategy clearly doesn't. Even if it feels like the safer strategy, he's not having enough success with it.
With the outside?
Yes.
Exactly. That's why I'm saying he should get inside and make it a coastal fight.
Even if it seems as though it's more dangerous.
Yeah. It's not more dangerous inside. It's more dangerous out there. He's getting killed out there.
Right, because Alvarez uses that strong jab, and then he gets those nice hooks to the body in.
And he has to have room for that.
Alvarez kind of missed with that right hand, bounced off the shoulder of Hatton.
See that? See, the room is getting with that hook. You can't give a puncher that kind of room.
Break! Breaks!
You see Alvarez now walking in with his hands down. Because he has not been able to land the shot really clean when Hatton's in a defensive posture. Roy, it looks to me like he wants to sucker Hatton into an exchange.
He does. That's the shots he wants right there, because Hatton's giving him room to throw those shots.
Down go!
And Max, you pointed out earlier, his punches just sound differently, just like that left hook to the body.
He's definitely a strong puncher.
Like a bass drum.
I mentioned Hatton had only been stopped once in his career. It was his 16th pro fight in England against David Keir in the fourth round at 150 pounds.
Don't hold. Break. Get out of there.
Alvarez opens up at the end of the eighth.
Matthew Hatton earning his money tonight.
Next Saturday night, tune in for a very special HBO Sports doubleheader. We'll premiere the documentary Running Rebels of UNLV, an in-depth look at one of the best and most colorful college basketball teams of all time. Larry Johnson, Greg Anthony, Stacey Augmon, and of course the man with the towel, Coach Jerry Tarkanian. That same night, it's live World Championship Boxing with pound-for-pound candidate Sergio Martinez, fresh off his one-punch destruction of Paul Williams, taking on undefeated Sergey Zinzurik.
Here's a beautiful combination. One, he must have copied off of me. I just can't believe it. A beautiful overhand right, then a left hook to the body that really takes the win out of an opponent when he doesn't see it coming. I think Eddie Mustafa Muhammad may have had the best left hook to the body until this kid. He may join us now.
By the way, Mickey Ward had a pretty good damn left hook to the body.
Yeah, he did too. I must admit it.
Well, I think before we put him in your club, he's got to accomplish a little bit more on the world championship level.
Well, I wasn't saying in my club totally. I was talking about that left body shot.
Cotto, when he was younger, especially with
he
the hook
had
to
a
the
good
body.
One too.
And of course, Joe Frazier, and the list goes on.
See, why would he back up right there? That's what he wants. That's what he should have kept. I don't understand why you back up and give this kid room to punch.
You're tired? You didn't make weight. You didn't anticipate the guy be around in the ninth round.
Yeah, but he didn't have to make the weight.
Right. Just that it indicates a certain level of seriousness in training.
It does. It does.
If he were fighting, you know, Manny Pacquiao, Alvarez, something tells me he'd be on weight.
As many shots as he takes, that might not be the only thing he'd be on.
No, wait.
You keep in mind, he is only 20 years old. Stop. He is a prodigy.
Well, we understand that, but you said it. I didn't say it. You said it.
Hey, with that said, though, Hatton has thrown 30 punches to Alvarez's 16 in this round.
Well, Alvarez is a little tired from throwing those big punches, too. I told you. Big shots take a lot out of a fighter.
Especially the one catching him.
Seems like whenever he needs to, though, he finds that left hook to the body.
As he knows, that will keep Hatton weak. Oh, good shot. Good shot.
That's what he's been looking for all fight, Alvarez. He wants to catch Hatton in an exchange with Hatton a left hook.
Hatton landed a good left hook.
Alvarez steps in with a combination. Hatton trying to tie him up, and does.
Alvarez threw a beautiful triple left hook.
Showing his grit. Alvarez's power. Good uppercut inside from Alvarez. Hatton holds on.
He better.
10 seconds. Yes, or no. Stop.
And Hatton is as game as a biting sow.
End of round number 9. Well, earlier tonight on the undercard, James Kirkland, absent from the ring for 2 years, back in action. Ashanti Gibbs, no resistance, as Kirkland finishes him off in 34 seconds of round number 1 in a middleweight fight. Then I saw Danny Jacobs out of Brooklyn, 21-1, working with Freddie Roach, taking on Robert Kuehler of St. Paul, Minnesota. And easy work for Jacobs. Another first round stoppage, 144 of round number 1.
Ray Corona calls a halt. Working with Freddie Roach, and Freddie Roach turns 51 years old today.
Yep, and then Seth Mitchell, the heavyweight, taking on Charles Davis of Tucson. Davis with a below 500 record. Easy win for Mitchell. Dropped him 4 times in the fight, 3 times in round number 2. And that's how it ended. So a look at some of the highlights that spanned less than 3 minutes of action. Let's check in with Harold Letterman through 9 here.
Okay, Bob, I've got it a shutout. I mean, 8 rounds for Canelo Alvarez, and of course, 1 round even when referee Lou Moret took away that point from Alvarez. And you know, I think Lou didn't want Alvarez to have a perfect 120 points, so he took a point. But be as it may, Canelo Alvarez pitched in a shutout. And, you know, I keep wondering, I keep saying to myself, if Canelo wore Reyes gloves, would he have gotten this guy out a long time ago? Because he's hitting him a lot of tremendous shots, but he's wearing that same boxing glove that Eric Morales used to protect his hands, that Floyd Mayweather used to protect his hands, and the padding is out in front. Anyway, 8 rounds to nothing. Canelo Alvarez with 1 even.
I don't think he would have gotten him out. I think Hatton's done a good job of protecting his chin, Roy.
Yeah, he has. Yep. He's done a superb job of protecting that chin. He's gotten caught with a lot of good body shots, but he has protected his chin very good tonight.
Roy, do you get to a point here where you just say, if you're like Alvarez, all right, I got to try to figure out a way to finish this guy off?
No, you do what he's doing. You know, he's taking his time. He's being smart. I mean, this is his first world title, and he's still holding the composure like a veteran. And you got to love that about this kid.
He is a veteran. 5 years in the game already. It's amazing.
At 20 years old.
Yeah, this is his 223rd round as a pro.
Yeah.
For Hatton, this is his 309th round.
Yeah, but I can guarantee you, Hatton hasn't faced the competition that Canelo has.
That's right. And you know, whatever you say about whatever his limitations ultimately may be, Canelo, he is a prodigy at the age of 20 to be fighting at the level he's fighting and to already have the resume he has.
He's landing a beautiful hook when Hatton is coming in. Oh,
low blow by Hatton.
Oh.
And then Alvarez hits him off the break and a little acting there by Hatton.
Yeah.
Lou Moret wants Hatton to get up.
Yeah. Stop Burhausen in. Climb in. Come on. Go. Go. Keep him up.
Now
oh,
Alvarez
that hurt him.
Left and right.
Yeah, that hurt him bad.
Alvarez doesn't allow himself to get tied up this time.
Mm-mm.
Oh, he wants to finish off Hatton here.
Now, I love how Alvarez pivots around and throws that left hook. I used to do that a lot as a young fighter.
Straight right hand off the left. Combination from Alvarez, Hatton comes back at him.
And I love the way Hatton came back at Alvarez after that beating.
Hatton is game.
Breathe. Did he caught you? Did he catch you?
No.
Bring his legs up. There's a Vaseline.
Listen, we've got two rounds, haven't we? Matt, we've got two rounds now.
All right, let's start settling down. Okay, that was a push.
Right.
Here you see Hatton, while they're holding, land a bad left low blow. Looked like it was almost purposely. And Canelo responded to it, came with a beautiful left hook to the jaw. Then Hatton thinks about Hollywood and goes down for a minute, hoping the ref will do something.
Trying to win an extra point there.
Yeah, Canelo comes back and throws a left hook with right hand and lands with a beautiful double right hand right off of that lead left hook.
We begin round 11. A 154-pound belt at stake. Saul Alvarez of Mexico, 20 years of age, 35-0-1 with 26 knockouts against Matthew Hatton.
It's a shame Matthew Hatton isn't a really good fighter, you know? Too many really good fighters don't fight with this kind of resolve. And he does.
You know, it's like most of the time the guys that have the talent don't use the talent, and the guys who are a little bit less talented work the hardest.
Which is why when you get a Manny Pacquiao, you thank your lucky stars.
Very few fighters can put the whole package together.
Let him go. Break. Break. Listen to my command.
You know what this kid reminds me of? Canelo reminds me of an early Darren Van Horn.
Break. Let him go.
Van Horn was slick like this, had good side to side.
Schoolboy.
Yes, he was.
Yeah.
He turned pro about 15 years old and became a junior middleweight champ pretty early, too.
And Iran Barkley ran over him in two rounds eventually.
Exactly, but this is who this kid reminds me of right away.
But with more talent, I think, a bigger puncher.
Yeah, this kid is a much bigger puncher.
Break! Break!
Hatton's endured a lot of punishment, but he keeps hanging in there and trying to get his big shots off of his own.
And with more fans, too, Roy, you know, it's so rare for a fighter this young to connect with people the way he's connected.
Well, he's totally different in every aspect, you know. He's not built like a normal Mexican fighter. He doesn't look like a normal Mexican fighter. He doesn't box like a normal Mexican fighter, so.
Yet he gives the crowd their money's worth.
That's exactly right, and he's not afraid to share punches. Oh, good body shot.
Good left hook to the body by Alvarez.
He brings it. He's right in your face. He's definitely an action-packed figure waiting to happen in boxing. And people know that. This is why they gather around him, because they want to see action. They want to see a guy who doesn't care about getting hit, and that's exactly what Alvarez is. He tries to avoid it, but he really doesn't care.
Now the drama here, as I see it, is Matthew Hatton's championship. Can he go the distance while trying to win the whole time? Not just last the distance, but go the distance while fighting hard and still trying to win. And that's what's on the line for him.
Breathe, breathe.
Es el último round,
this is the last round.
Dale.
It's the last round, okay?
That line in the ropes, right? Yep, the last round, we've got to get to the end of it, haven't we? Yep. We've climbed the mountain, haven't we? You remember? Yep, Matt, listen to me. Don't go macho-ing and try and go swinging there. Use your jab nice and defensive. Are you listening? Yep. We're well behind now. Come on. All the way to the belt.
Breathe deeply.
Listo.
Last round, okay? Okay. Ready, he's gonna come out with everything. So Alvarez and Matthew Hatton, 12th and final round, 154-pound belt at stake. No knockdowns in the fight. Alvarez has landed the huge power shots. Hatton has hung in there, though.
Alvarez has beat Miguel Cotto's brother. Now he's going to beat Ricky Hatton's brother. And pretty soon it's going to be time to stop fighting the brothers and start fighting the actual guys.
Well, Ricky's definitely big enough for him right now.
For sure.
Ooh. Thumping right hands from Alvarez to the head of Hatton.
Laid on his right side, Hatton did, and Alvarez did just what he was supposed to do, which is shoot that right hand.
The referee is looking at Hatton very closely now. That's a shot.
Counter right hand from Hatton.
Don't hold him, Matt. Don't hold.
He's giving it one hell of an effort now. I must admit that. With the limited tools that he has, he's giving it one heck of an effort.
Yeah, I mean, he changed the story of the fight from can Alvarez stop him to can Hatton go the distance.
Hatton.
10,000 fans here in Anaheim to see the headliner, Saul Alvarez, the 20-year-old out of Mexico. Using left hands to the body all night long. Hatton with a combination of his own.
Break.
I tell you, I like the combination of Alvarez.
Don't hold, Matt. Don't hold.
Don't hold, easy for you to say.
Oh, good
left
shot.
And a right to the ear.
That hurt him bad.
Hurt Hatton's on wobbly legs.
What happens when you don't hold?
So now we'll tell that to the referee.
Oh, Hatton's game. He's going to make it to the end.
Matthew Hatton's a real fighter. Canelo Alvarez, it looks like to me, is going to be a real good fighter.
Maybe even great.
Saul Alvarez Canelo Cinnamon from Guadalajara. At 20 years of age, looks like he's on his way to his first title bout. Here are the judges. Raul Caiz Sr., 44 title fights on his resume. He had the fight even in the John against Juarez fight. Jack Reese, two title fights on his resume. Had Darchinian ahead in his stoppage of Myers. And Joel Scobie, two title fights on his resume. All three judges that'll be scoring the fight tonight between Alvarez and Hatton. I don't think there's a lot of mystery as to what the numbers are going to look like. As you get a look at Harold Letterman's card, he had it a shutout. The seventh round, Alvarez lost a punch. Lost a point for hitting Hatton on the break and was deducted a point. Alvarez said, we spoke with him yesterday, this is preparation for taking the next step to the elite level. Looks like he's going to add a belt at 154 pounds and taking that step against Matthew Hatton here tonight in Anaheim, California. And his popularity will just continue to grow. Game effort for Matthew Hatton as he absorbed a lot of punishment over 12 rounds. Let's go to Michael Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Honda Center, Anaheim, California, we go to the scorecards. The winner will be the new WBC Super Welterweight World Champion. All three judges, Jack Reese, Raul Caiz Sr., and Joel Scobie, scored about the same, 119 to 108. The winner by unanimous decision, Damas y Caballeros, de Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, Saul Canelo Alvarez.
Cinnamon has a belt as he dismantles Matthew Hatton over 12 rounds with a very pleasing style. As we take a look at the final CompuBox punch stats in the fight, you see that Alvarez threw more. He landed at 47%, 294 to 138 for Hatton. And his power punches were just key with the hooks to the body and the multiple punch combinations. 486 thrown, 257 landed, 53%, as we focus in on punch zone and see where a lot of the damage was done. To the right, the punches landed on Hatton. 88 to the body, devastating hooks. And 205 to the head for that total of 293. The body work opened everything up. Max is standing by with Saul Alvarez.
Congratulations, Canelo, on a dominant victory. What do you think of your performance tonight?
No, yo creo que fue muy bien, ¿no? Mi rival es un rival muy fuerte que sabe. Yo creo que la gente que criticaba que era un mal rival aquí se dio cuenta, ¿no? Es un gran rival que tiene experiencia. Le golpeaba y me amarraba. Tenía.
He's a good rival, and the people had criticized him, but he showed he's a true rival. He would hurt me, he would hold on to me, and he would give me some troubles. But he's a rival with a great experience.
As usual, a lot of people showed up for a Canelo Alvarez fight. But not only that, they seemed to get very loud when there was action. Why do you think that is?
Sí, así es. Aquí a toda la gente quiero agradecerle su apoyo. Siempre me han apoyado muy bien.
I want to thank all the people that have supported me.
Yo les dije que les iba a pagar con buenas peleas, con títulos mundiales, y este es mi primer sueño. Faltan muchos y son para todos ustedes.
I told them that I would give them world championships, I would give them great fights, and this is my first world championship, and this is for you.
But why the connection with you? You seem to have a special connection with the fans and they to you. Why?
No lo sé, no lo sé. Estoy muy agradecido con Dios por haberme dado esto, esta gente tan linda que me apoya mucho. Estoy muy agradecido con Dios, con toda la gente, y pues voy a seguir dándoles muchas grandes peleas.
I don't know why, but I thank God, I thank the people, and I thank the people for coming out, and I'm going to give them much more and much better fights.
Okay, you have a belt now. It's a promotional tool for bigger fights. Are you ready for bigger fights? When can we expect you taking on the stars of the division?
Como les acabo de decir, este es mi primer sueño. Vienen las grandes, quiero los mejores, y voy a ser el próximo gran mexicano que venga a todos.
As I said, this is my dreams. This is the first one of many more will come, and I will have more fights with the big names, and I will be one of the big names for Mexico.
Are you a year away from that point? 6 months, 18 months, you're still very young.
No lo sabemos. Hay que esperar. Hay que esperar unas dos peleas más, porque no nomás quiero pelear, sino quiero ir a ganar, y eso estoy haciendo ahorita, ¿no? Preparándome para ganarle a los mejores, voy en el camino.
We don't know, we've got to wait a bit, maybe two more fights, but that's what we need to do. We need to prepare to get more, better fights and prepare to have the bigger fights.
Thanks, Canelo.
Gracias, gracias a toda la gente, y nada más quiero decir que viva México!
Matthew Hatton, as game as they come, you seem to be fighting to win the whole way, even though it looked like you had no shot. Why?
Well, you know, I'm a fighter through and through, and I really do think I've shared the ring there with a great fighter. You know, Canelo, fantastic fighter. But, you know, when you get the opportunity to challenge for a world title, you've got to take it. But nothing I seemed to do made an impression on him, so I'm going to move back down to welterweight. I mean, he never hurt me in the fight. You know, he's got a good variety, fantastic fighter. Wish him all the best in his career. And I move back down to welterweight and look for a world title opportunity there.
Can you give us a scouting report on Alvarez? He seemed to be heavy-handed. What do you think of his skills? Tell us what it's like to be in there with him.
Yeah, you know, I give him the full respect. He's got a good variety of shots. He's an intelligent fighter. He's a strong fighter. I just think he was just too big in there tonight. You know, I'm not too sure what the weight difference was on the night. I take nothing away from him. He's the better fighter. I move back down to my natural weight division and look for a world title opportunity there.
Thanks for putting up a great fight, Matthew. Bob.
All right, thank you very much, Max. Matthew Hatton, very classy in defeat. He's going to move back down to 147. We posed the question to you at the beginning of this main event. Does Alvarez have the goods to be great from a fighting standpoint? What's your impression after seeing him live and in person?
Well, it still has a little ways to go. However, I do think this. I think that God has definitely blessed this kid, and he definitely knows this, because when God gives you a blessing that you can't understand, which is the way he got all these people following him already, it's something beyond his understanding, my understanding, your understanding. So God is definitely with this kid. He's given him a lot of talent to work with. Now we have to see where he goes from here. Can he make that leap yet to be great? I don't know.
Well, the one interesting part about it too, Roy, is the fact that he gets hit just enough, as he did by Hatton tonight, that's going to make it exciting along the way. Also earlier tonight, Adrian Broner won a unanimous decision victory against Daniel Ponce de Leon in a fight probably a little closer than one of the judges' scorecards had it. Max Kellerman rejoins us here at ringside. Your overall impressions of what you saw here tonight, especially from Canelo?
The fans don't just turn out for him, they love him. And boxing fans, I think, generally are looking for something. We want something, and you could feel it whenever the action would heat up, the desire for him to give them something, and he does give them something to root for, and I think he's going to give us things to root for in the not-too-distant future. Win, lose, or draw, he looks to be an exciting fighter for, he's 20 years old, for years to come.
Yeah, he's got an exciting style. He's willing to open it up. He takes some shots. He's going to be in some very intriguing matchups as he continues to move up the ladder. But the end result is tonight, in his first campaign at 154 pounds, he walks out of here tonight with a win against Matthew Hatton, and he leaves with a 154-pound title belt. If you missed any of tonight's telecast, you can catch it in its entirety at the dates and times listed below. For more boxing updates, there are now lots of places to go. HBO's Facebook page, HBO's Twitter feed, and as always, HBO.com. Go to our website now to sign up for the official HBO boxing newsletter. Also go to HBO.com starting Monday for new installments of Ring Life featuring featherweight champion Euriorkis Gamboa. Next on HBO, stay tuned for Robin Hood. So for our entire Boxing After Dark crew, I'm Bob Papa saying goodnight from Anaheim, California.
This has been a presentation of HBO Sports.